they call 2021 the Great Reset. And I'm going to explain why. But before I get into it, I want to let those who don't know me get to know me a little bit. I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. BusyWorksBeats.com. I've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to win Grammys. Some have gone to win Emmys. Some have gone to work with the top artists in the world, like Drake, Young Thug, YG, Post Malone, Ray Sherman, French Montana, on and on and on. I'm going to get one big list and just hand that to you guys. I work with the top audio companies in the world, like Isotope, Image Line, Arturia, Sweetwater, Universal Audio, etc., etc. I'm outside walking my dog right now. And so you hear a lot of talk about the Great Reset. And forgive the wind because I'm outside. Come on, King. The Great Reset is about creating a new pyramid. Now, before I get into that principle, I just want to explain what you have to do during the Great Reset. Now, what I do every single year when I have confusion and kind of lack of understanding is I have to recalibrate. Okay, so I'm visiting family right now. But what I have to do every year is recalibrate. And what does that mean? So, for example, if you grab a scale and you place a weight on that scale, the scale will be inaccurate unless you calibrate the scale. It doesn't know how much a kilogram weighs if it doesn't have any reference. So it's just guessing. And a lot of us are just guessing where we are. So whenever you feel confused, you need to understand where you are. You need to measure and analyze where you are financially, mentally, emotionally. And you need to have metrics that you can look at and quantify, because the way humans work, we understand through relativity. We understand through reference, value through reference. So we don't even understand what value is until we understand the contrast. Come on, kid. Goodness. Dog's yanking me everywhere. Forgive me here. So you need to reset your mind. Now the question is, how do you reset your mind? We need to have a reference point. So during the year, you may have noticed that your finances may have gotten out of shape, or you may have gotten out of shape during the quarantine lockdown, or friendships and relationships may have gotten out of shape. And that's because you forgot the reference point. You forgot how hard you used to work because you lost sight, you know, out of sight, out of mind. What you don't see, you don't measure. And what you observe, you measure. And what gets measured gets managed. And if you want to reset for 2021, you have to reset mentally, emotionally, with your team, financially, all those different things. And the way you do that is by having a reference and having a metric system that you can use to calculate how far off you are from that target. So again, you have to determine what you're trying to fix. If it's finances and you know you need to have a certain amount of money in your bank account, you need to say, okay, you need to measure from the year to the date. So a lot of people just measure from the top of the month at the top of the year to the current date. What you actually have to measure, let me walk this way because we're going into the wind. What you actually have to measure is last year's performance, or the good year's performance on that date versus that day, not what happened last week, because it's not showing you where you should be. It's showing you where you are right now. So again, let me say that one more time. If you are having a weird financial month, you need to measure your best year for that month, and you need to measure against that. You don't measure against what just happened last week, because if you're in the crap, you can't see that you're in the crap. You have to step away to see that you're in the crap. And so the same exact thing goes for emotions. If you're kind of in emotions, you need to revisit last year, the same time. Where were you at emotionally? Were you happy? Were you sad? Do you have a journal? Do you have video documenting your energy? Where was your energy at? A lot of us don't even realize how low energy we are until we see somebody who has super high energy. And when I'm on the phone with like friends like Jacob, for example, when I was feeling down, I was like, man, I feel bad for pulling you down, because his good energy was so high that I instantly saw my low energy. But at the time, I didn't realize how low that energy was until there was a contrast. Okay, so we need to understand the Great Reset has to be about recalibrating that scale of emotions, finances, relationship. You have to reset. You have to have a reference point of what's good, because again, if we're just guessing to judge what's good, like a beat, for example, if I had no idea what a Dr. Dre record sounded like, or whatever your favorite Michael Jackson record, then I wouldn't know what good sounds like. I would just be guessing. And if I'm guessing, then I don't really know what excellence is, greatness is, okay? And we have to not redefine it, but we have to make sure that's not my mask on the ground. Even if it is, I'll grab another one. But I usually wear my mask outside, just being candid with you, but I wanted to do a video and I didn't want to be all muffled and stuff. But if you don't know what greatness looks like, you have nothing to measure against. So for example, these geese right here. Look at this whole pond of geese, okay? So what do? They're not here all year long. They're only here to reset, okay? So when they're flying, going from wherever they came from to come here, they don't understand what, well, I don't want to say they don't understand, because you can get to magnetism and how birds are constructed to have certain detectors in their brain. So I'm not going to get into the theory behind it. But if you think about it, when they're coming here, this is their reference point of what's good. So if they never knew what this pond looked like to gather, they would just be flying endlessly until they found anything. Now that pond has enough space for them. Okay, so there's hundreds of geese. I'm talking about hundreds. Okay, now they're not all back there, but sometimes they'll fill up the entire pond and take up the entire space. But if they didn't have a defined location that was proven to give them the result that they needed, which is to house all the geese, then they'd be flying around, spending all their energy to migrate and end up in a place that they didn't actually want to go. And then that could actually kill off their flock. Okay, so they had a reference point to return back to. So when you're recalibrating, I want you to think, what is the great reset for you? How are you going to define that for your life this year? Now, if you're talking about 2021 and all the talk you hear about the great reset, it's actually talking about financial reset. And I'll kind of keep this short because I don't want to talk too high over your head. It's that, oh, look at the sunlight here. I need to shave. I need to do all this. And I just have that look where I just kind of like woke up. Look, so forgive me here. I'm looking ashy and crashy here. I like the light here, though. But anyway, the Great Reset is about a financial reset. So it's going from a system to another system. And the key to it is understanding it as a pyramid. So just by default, when you enter the traditional music industry, you're at the bottom of a pyramid. And the only way you can gain value in that pyramid without going through gatekeepers is to build a pyramid beneath you. For example, I'm going to be short about this, but imagine the guy at the top of the pyramid is the owner. He gets the most percentage. The people at the bottom get the least percentage. And it was shown in a study that musicians and artists were only paid 13% of their work for their work. And what that means is that they're at the bottom of the pyramid. The other 87% is going to everybody else at the top of that pyramid. And there's different layers to a pyramid. You have the top, you have the middle, you have the bottom. So where do you sit in that pyramid? Now, that's defined by institutions. That's defined by things that are already set up, systems that are already set up. But what's happening right now is that we're going to a decentralized monetary system, at least the beginning of it. Now, what does that actually mean? It's a new system. And so if you want to be at the top of that system, this is what people talk about when they say the early adapters of something. They're talking about the people who get in early because they end up at the top, okay, at the top of the pyramid. So the Great Reset is allowing people to go from the bottom of an existing system or an existing pyramid to have the chance to be at the top of another pyramid. That's when you see kids go from broke to having like $200,000 worth of Bitcoin, not because they earn $200,000, but because the value of Bitcoin went up as people were speculating the market value. And so it went up like 10,000% or something wild. So if people bought even $1,000 worth of Bitcoin, they're sitting on something nice right now if they got in early, okay? Because they were at the top of that pyramid. And the way pyramids expand is by lessening itself at the bottom, bringing in new people underneath them, okay? And that's what's happening. So I want you to think of everything like a pyramid. Whenever you're thinking about a reset, think about it as percentage at the top is the most, percentage at the bottom is the least, and you need to figure out where you are in the pyramid of whatever you're measuring. So a pyramid of finance, a pyramid of emotions, a pyramid of, you know, your goals for life. Where are you? Where are you in that system? Where are you in the pyramid? And once you measure where you are, you'll have a lot more accuracy to make better decisions to go where you want to go. a little windy here. I want to send it 10 minutes. It's game from BusyWorksBeats.com.